2 weeks ago, I attended a wonderful occasion at the Indian Hall in Pukekohe. It was organised by the New Zealand Indian Association to farewell the Governor-General, Sir Anand Satinyand. It was a great occasion and had people from all over New Zealand attending to mark what has been an extremely successful tenure as Governor-General. As everybody knows, he was the first Indian Governor-General to New Zealand, and certainly the local community were hugely proud of his achievements and the way he carried out his very important office. So it was a great honour to be there, and particularly at the Indian Hall in Pukekohe, which is the largest such hall anywhere in New Zealand. I also attended on Monday night the Kawakawa Bay Community Association. This is in the heart of my electorate by the coast, and they were very keen for me to address them on both national and local issues. What I found particularly interesting was their great concern for issues such as early childhood care. They're a small community, but they are indeed part of the backbone of our economy. They're farmers, fishermen, and very much involved with primary agriculture. The problem for them is that they have a fluctuating population, and their local kindergarten is under tremendous stress from the obvious volatility of numbers. At the end of the evening, we resolved that the important thing is that policies be put in place to ensure that small rural communities do have special exemptions to ensure that even if their numbers do go up and down, they are sustained through the good and the bad periods in terms of funding. Because otherwise, these really important early childhood supports are lost in the rural communities, often forever, and they are very, very important to them. Last week, we finished the inquiry into the early detection and treatment of prostate cancer. I was very pleased to get this report out as chairman of the Health Select Committee. There are something like 3,000 cases of prostate cancer detected every year and 680 deaths. Many of these are preventable, and we learnt from urologists like Dr. Robin Smart that in countries like Austria, in the Tyrol, they've been able to halve the number of deaths from prostate cancer by a variety of mechanisms, including encouraging men to undergo PSA testing. Although the PSA test is not as accurate as ideal, it does give very useful information to men as to whether they should go on for further procedures. So that in New Zealand, in 2004, the Ministry of Health was actually actively warning men not to have PSA tests. Our strong recommendation was that the Ministry of Health encourage men to see their GPs to seek advice on whether or not they should have PSA testing from age 45, and if they've got a family history of prostate cancer, from age 40. We believe this may be a turning point for the early diagnosis and treatment of prostate cancer in New Zealand. Finally, this afternoon in the Parliament, we have the third reading of the debate on the Misuse of Drugs Amendment Act. This deals with methamphetamine precursors, and also the banning of synthetic cannabinoids or drug preparations like Kronic. This latter part has become particularly worrisome in New Zealand because over the last few months we've seen dairies up and down the countries stocking these psychoactive tablets, making them available to young people and pretty well normalising the situation. They're sold by manufacturers that are ruthless, that are cunning and that are determined to make money out of it, no matter what happens to our young people. Consequently, we're putting in an amendment that will stop the sale of these over the next year until the advice of the Law Commission can be taken, whereby the manufacturers must prove the safety of this group of drugs.